Hi, my name is Rodney from the Tampa Bay National Weather Service Office. Today we will cover tornadoes and thunderstorms, the next topic for Severe Weather Awareness Week 2014. Let's get started. Tornadoes are one of the most destructive weather forces across the country and can occur any time during the year, day or night. An average of 1,200 tornadoes occur each year and cause 86 fatalities and 1,500 injuries nationwide. In 2013, there were 36 tornadoes reported statewide, with 14 of those occurring here in West Central and Southwest Florida. Tornadoes are classified using the Enhanced Fujita Scale, which ranks storms from EF0 to EF5. EF0 and EF1 are typical here in Florida. Last year, all 14 tornadoes that were reported in West Central and Southwest Florida were either EF0 or EF1. EF2 and EF3 are rare in West Central Florida. Most can't forget the EF3 that went through parts of Sumter and Lake County in 2007. EF4 are very rare in West Central Florida and haven't been recorded in the last few decades. EF5 is extremely rare in West Central Florida and haven't been reported in recent history. No one was injured or killed in Florida during the last year's tornadoes. There are three different scenarios where tornadoes form in Florida. Frontal system tornadoes occur mostly in the late winter and spring, forming along a preceding squall line. Sea breeze or boundary collision tornadoes are the most common and happen mainly in the late spring and summer. Tropical cyclone band tornadoes form on the outer bands of landfalling tropical cyclones. In general, tornadoes form when rapidly rising air in a thunderstorm updraft combines with an increase in wind speed or change in wind direction known as shear. The larger the shear, the greater the rotation, and thus the better chance a tornado will form. Here are some safety rules. If a tornado warning has been issued for your area, seek shelter immediately. If you are inside, seek shelter in an underground shelter, basement, or the innermost room on the lowest level away from the windows. If you do not have time to get to the lowest level, get under a bed. At school, get under your desk. In open country, seek a nearby shelter, if time permits. If not, lie flat in the nearest depression, ditch, or culvert. Cover your head with your arms. Abandon mobile homes and go to a firmly built shelter. Vehicles are extremely dangerous in a tornado. If the tornado is visible far away and the traffic is light, you may be able to drive out of its path by moving at right angles to the tornado. Otherwise, park the car as quickly and safely as possible out of the traffic lanes. Get out and seek shelter in a sturdy building. Avoid seeking shelter under bridges, which may cause deadly traffic hazards, while offering little protection against flying debris. For the second half of today's topic, we'll focus on thunderstorms. Thunderstorms are almost a daily occurrence in Florida between June and September, mainly because of the sea breeze. This figure shows the average number of thunderstorm days each year throughout the U.S. So we can see that areas from Tampa Bay south to Lee County have to deal with thunderstorms 100 days a year. All thunderstorms are dangerous with lightning, heavy rainfall, and gusty winds, but today we're going to focus on the most dangerous type, the severe thunderstorm. One definition of a severe thunderstorm is a thunderstorm that has wind gusts exceeding 58 miles per hour. These winds can be classified as either straight-line winds or downburst winds. The damage created by these winds can be equivalent to that seen from a tornado and can level large areas of forest and housing developments. The other criteria to be classified as a severe thunderstorm is hail of 1 inch or greater in diameter. Hail is more common in late spring, early summer, but can occur any time of the year. Hail is very destructive for property and crops, causing over $1 billion in damage each year. If you are caught outside in a hailstorm, seek shelter immediately, as hail can cause serious injuries. Remember to always plan ahead and check the forecast at weather.gov/Tampa. For more tips on tornado and thunderstorm safety, check these websites. This concludes the topic for today. The next training topic will be temperature extremes and wildfires.